Introduction. Complex information systems, CIS, are nowadays the core of a large number of companies. And therefore, there is a large need to analyze various system configuration and choose the optimal solution during design and even operation of the information system. In this paper we propose a common approach, Berta and Urbe, 2007, based on modeling and simulation. The aim of simulation is to calculate some performance metrics which should allow to compare different configuration taking into consideration technical, like performance, and economical, like price, aspects. There is a large number of event-driven computer network simulators, like OBNET, NS2, QualNet, OMNET++ or SNET/Prime SSFLU, 2006, Nicole et al., 2003. However, they are mainly focused on a low-level simulation, TCP/IP packets. It is obvious that increasing the system details causes the simulation becoming useless due to the computational complexity and a large number of required parameter values to be given. On the other hand, a high level of modeling could not allow to record required data for system measure calculation. Therefore, the level of system model details should be defined by requirements of the system measure calculation, Wakowiak, 2009. Modeling and simulation based on TCP/IP packets level results in a large number of events during simulation and therefore in a long simulation time. It is a very good approach if one plans to analyze the influence of the traffic on the network performance. However, in modern information systems, high-speed local networks are used. In a result for a large number of information systems, except media streaming ones, the local network traffic influence on the whole system performance is negligible. Therefore, we want to propose a novel approach based on a higher level than TCP/IP packets. We will focus on a business service realized by an information system, Gold et al., 2007, and functional aspects of the system, i.e. performance aspects of business service realized by an information system, like buying a course in the Internet Courses Store. We assume that the main goal, taken into consideration during design and operation of the SIS, is to fulfill the user requirements, which could be seen as some requirements to perform a user tasks within a given time limit. Therefore, the presented in the lecture modeling and simulation will be focused on a process of execution of a user request, understand as a sequence of task realized on technical services provided by the system. The structure of the lecture is as follows. In section 2, a model of information system is given. In section 3, information on simulator implementation is given. Next, exemplars information system is analyzed and simulation results are presented. It is followed by information on graphical user interface. Finally, there are conclusions and plans for further work.